Goes across to Kane, who's got a little room. Patrick Kane gets the line, stick handling, nice into the backhand, shooting. Oh! Oh, Patrick Kane! Tee up the highlight reel on that one!
Unbelievable backhand shot. We've seen that before, but he turns Jan Hayda inside out, watches his feet, gets him crossing over, puts it back between his legs. Right there, and then up over the shoulder. There was literally no room there. Up over that left shoulder of Varlamov. Watch from this angle. Well, actually a little more room than I thought. Varlamov was deep in his net.
Puck playing on the far side, and Sharp rolls it across now for Kane. Kane across the line, crisscrosses. Takes the drop pass, carries it through the backhand shot. He scores!
Patrick Kane on the backhand from such a bad angle, controls the puck, keeps it, and scores from there. The only place you can score on a goaltender from that bad an angle, no matter how big they are, is that top corner right underneath the bar, and he hits all of the bars. I think it goes off the post, off the crossbar, off of everything, but it's in the back of the net.
Down low for Kane. Kane, nice move around, Draisaitl, here is Kane! Scores! Patrick Kane gives Jeff Glass his first win in the National Hockey League in his first ever start, and he is mobbed by his teammates.
Patrick Kane just took over. Gets the puck, and he rolls. Just makes a beautiful move on Leon Draisaitl, then on Cam Talbot. But again, first play is stopped, but Patrick Kane stays with it. Left-right move, back to the backhand, stops right there, finishes it off.
Seabrook to Pat Kane, dangled by Yuri Hudler. Backhand shot, he scores! What a shot! Pat Kane's first of the series tie game.
Wasn't, I don't think, worried about getting beat to the outside, but he just didn't have a good stick. And this backhander, much like the hat-trick goal he had in the Vancouver series, just an absolute roof. I mean, he just drills that up and over Chris Osgood. But it's the speed getting some finally open ice without any backside pressure, and couldn't come at a bigger time.
Hey, Baumeister. Then Ponick got it back. In front, Kane, around a check to the backhand. He tried to shot. Oh, and he had a rebound. The Hawks win! Hawks win! Patrick Kane! Elliott arguing about it, but this was a good goal call on the ice, and Patrick Kane has kept his team season alive. A huge play in double OT.
Well, Patrick Kane with an incredible move right in front of Brian Elliott. Looked like he was going to shoot the puck, but he avoided two St. Louis Blues players. Richard Ponick should get an assist on that goal. Jonathan Toews tying up in front of the net with Jay Bouwmeester.
Of Montoya, that's the help he's looking for. Kane dancing in. Kane scores! What a goal by Patrick Kane!
Toews does this so well. There's the first chance, first of all, by Kane. But watch Toews here. There, that quick stick. And then he whacks it right to Kane, and then Kane with his magic. And all is that magic. There's that little play by Toews. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's just special.
3-on-2 with Kane and Versteeg. In comes Patrick Kane, walks in, spins, plays it across, Versteeg scores! Chris Versteeg with a broken stick fires it home, and with 5:08 to go in the third period, Chicago is within two.
Richard starts in the middle of the ice, and then he gets it to the right man, and what a pass coming up. 360 spinorama all the way over to the other side to Versteeg, who's been put back on that line. How about this play and pass from Patrick Kane? How do you beat that?
Patrick Kane carries it in, weaves in the middle with a spinorama setup. Hossa, what a goal! A spinorama setup from Patrick Kane, and Hossa finished it. We're tied.
To the outside for
Patrick Kane. He works himself into the middle of the ice. Everybody watching. Patrick Kane working on Tony Ludman. Look at Kane's head up. He sees where Hossa is to the left. He throws it to an area. And Big Hoss has a wide open net.
Patrick Kane is away at center, but he stumbled. Kane was an inch away from a breakaway. Pesci recovers on the backhand, and Kane scores. Somehow that backhand eludes James Reimer.
Kane toe picks. Now Kane, his whole career for the most part, when he uses this spinorama backhand play, he usually always goes short side shelf. Not sure if Reimer was thinking that. Reimer may have been a tad deep. Pesci bit on it, which is surprising to me because Kane uses that move on one-on-ones with regularity.
Oh, do you? That bounced off a skate, but it was a good bounce for the Hawks. Sharp able to get it out to the center ice. Kane makes an empty little move, gets it to the forehand. Takes the shot, he scores! Patrick Kane celebrates with the hometown crowd wearing Chicago jerseys along the glass.
You never know where he can go from there. Watch this little play with one hand right at the blue line. Whoops, a little in between the legs. He backs off the defender, Weber, and uses him as a screen and a terrific wrist shot right in the top shelf. Goes through Erhoff's feet, backs off. The other defenseman, that was Ruweedle, excuse me, used him as a screen and threw it right up over the shoulder.
3-on-2. Look at that as he played it back, but a steal! And here comes Kane! He scores! D-to-D, a rolling puck. Patrick Kane anticipates where the pass is going. Forehand, backhand, top shelf. There you see the skill level of the leading scorer in the entire National Hockey League.
Make yourself big. Get your stick in the lane. Don't have it in the air. Have it on the ice. He has it on the ice.
This one turned back around and behind. Can be played further. A little twisting play. Score! It's Kane. It's 3. Adam McQuaid loses that puck, never gets it out. Panarin uses the area in behind the net. And then a backhand pass from Anisimov to Patrick Kane for goal number 42 on the season.
Angled on out for the turn.
Panarin to Kane, who opens up, but Panarin puts it in the wheelhouse, and Kane scores short side.
Almost impossible to defend when you see how quickly Kane and Panarin release the puck, not just shooting, but passing as well. Perfect timing by Panarin to Kane.
Keldon along the boards, Andrew Ladd, checked by Tober. Campbell holds the puck into the line, turns, won't shoot, Kane. Watched by Kimo Tiivanen to the net. And he stopped it. Where's the puck? It came loose on the other side. It's over. Patrick Kane has scored the goal. The Chicago Blackhawks' long drought is over.
And there it is.
There's the puck. What a remarkable end to a remarkable game, and what a season.
Let's watch as the puck goes through Layton and right in the corner. Wow, got stuck underneath the netting. Little juke and jive here as he's done so effectively. Gets outside position, and then once he saw it going around, there's his reaction.
Stopped 12 of them. Kane, spinorama scores! Patrick Kane! Oh, dear.
An artful, exotic spinorama and backhander that stunned Bachman on the short side. One-on-one against young Dillon. Shuts it down, spins it around, shades of Denny Savard as that one clicks in off the pipe.
The middle comes Brian Campbell heading for the net. Patrick Kane shoots, he scores!
And it's Patrick Kane showing his deftness with his hands and his deceptive speed. And this is just an absolutely perfectly placed shot.
I mean, for Roberto Luongo, he can't come out and challenge too much because there's a potential for Jonathan Toews at the other end.
Troy Brower holds the puck in. Bounced on Mitchell, a wraparound. Toews scores!
And the Canucks unable to get to the puck along the wall. A bad break, bounce off the glass, but a heads-up play by Pat Kane. The glass hit the puck hit a stanchion, bounced over Willie Mitchell, but this is just skill.
By him to center. Here's Kane with Toews. Kane, backhand shot, he scores!
And just simply beautiful technician with the puck. Outside, inside, and then a backhander. That's just unbeatable. For a goaltender, almost impossible to anticipate where this is going to be. Watch how he keeps his feet moving initially, then moves it laterally, and an absolute rocket.
Hats off to Boston. Here's another chance for Chicago. Net empty.
So this is just poor miscommunication by the LA Kings here. Jonathan Quick has to recognize that his defenseman, Robin Regier, is going to get beat to the puck by Bickle, and then it's just confusion after that, but there has to be better communication.
Guys, they think it's an icing. They think this is an icing.
Right away, and Regier had to play it. Did get it up on the glass. And the double back for high and fine to Bickle. Center score!
Justin Williams feels he's taken down behind the net right here, and that's why the giveaway right there, Bickle finds Kane. I think Justin Williams has an argument here.
It's an unfortunate set of circumstances.
Comes Chicago 2-on-1, and the pass!
Pinching. We had seen about 3 2-on-1s in the last 5 minutes, and similar to the Hossa goal the other night, that's how you're going to beat Jonathan Quick.